We're back now with that health headline about statins. 39 million Americans are already on the cholesterol-fighting pills. Now, a new study says that millions more are at risk and should be taking the drugs. Our senior medical contributor, Dr. Jennifer Ashton, is here with more. We're talking about, what's here, from 17 to 26 million more people?
Exactly. This is a big report. So let me explain to you. This is basically about two professional groups, the U.S. Preventive Service Task Force and the American Heart Association, and their respective guidelines about who meets criteria to be eligible for a statin medication to prevent heart disease. Okay. So again, you heard the numbers. U.S. Preventive Service Task Force is using this analysis estimates 17 million new prescriptions for statins. According to the American Heart Association, they used broader criteria. They got 26 million new statin prescriptions. Wow. We have to remember heart disease is the number one killer of men and women in the country. That's why this story is getting so much attention.
So what are the factors that determine whether or not you should be on statins?
So both groups are basically using the same risk factors. You're talking about age, you're talking about cholesterol, diabetes, high blood pressure, smoking, and then a calculated risk of a cardiac event over a 10-year period. So let me show you what I mean.
Okay.
I have some people here who are helping me today. So basically, if you look at those criteria, you would be in the Preventive Service Task Force. Maybe age between 40 and 75, you have a risk factor like high cholesterol, and your 10-year risk of a heart attack is over 10%. Maybe you just have diabetes, but don't worry, you're gonna make it. You might be under 40 years of age, but have one risk factor, and you might just have high cholesterol. These people would be in the American Heart Association numbers. That's why they wound up with more people. They broadened their criteria.
But we always hear about there's downsides, there are risks. What are those?
Exactly. So you always have to weigh risks versus benefits. Right. You have to take into account cost when you're talking about a medication. When you're talking about risks of statins, there's a low risk of muscle ache. There is an increased risk of diabetes development in women. But we have to be clear, this is something that has to be individualized patient to patient. And we have to remember, statins work in other ways than just lowering that number. And other things other than lifestyle can raise that number.
Okay. There are other lifestyle, not smoking, things like that.
100%, and 80% of heart disease preventable by modifying those risk factors.
Okay. By the way, you're all going to make it.
You're
going to
survive.
Thank you, Jim.